This is Bob Johnson's Computer Stuff. Today we are replacing the RAM on a GTAC V100 G4. It is just underneath this door here, and it's held on by five screws, I think that is. Once you have the last screw out, there's a place here to pry. Just pry the door up out of the way. There's mounting brackets on the underside, so if your unit came with options, there might be something attached there. There's two RAM slots here. The bottom one is obviously the only one occupied in our unit. You pull out on the pull tabs, slide the stick of RAM out. There is a notch so that you cannot put the RAM in backwards. If you have more than one stick of RAM, then obviously yours could get filled up, both of them. You want to make sure that it is firmly anchored before you snap it down into place. And then from there, it's just in reverse. After you put RAM in, you really want to turn it over and turn it on and make sure that it boots the whole way before you finish this repair. Sometimes bad RAM can cause the unit to not turn on at all. Other times it can cause the unit to blue screen during Windows booting. Other times it can go the whole way into Windows and then start blue screening whenever you try and run a program. So there's several different things that bad RAM can do, but this is just how to physically replace the RAM. And this is Bob Johnson's Computer Stuff. Today we replaced the RAM in a GTAC V100 G4. Thank you and have a good day.